Hello students, I am Professor Navneet Kaur from Department of Electronics and Communication, Sagar Institute of Research and Technology College. Today I will be discussing a lab practical of subject digital signal processing. Now first we will discuss the list of experiments. Here we have 10 practicals in our curriculum. First practical is write a MATLAB program to plot real and complex exponential sequences. Second is the plotting of impulse response of first order and second order discrete time system. Third experiment is to plot even and odd component of a signal. Fourth practical will deal with computing and plotting linear convolution of two signals. Fifth practical will have plotting of circular convolution of two signals. Now, sixth practical will be a program to compute DFT of a given signal and plot amplitude and phase spectrum. Seventh practical will be a program to compute Fourier coefficients of given signal and sketch its amplitude and phase spectrum. Eighth practical will be a MATLAB program to design Butterworth IR low pass filter, whereas Chebyshev IR low pass filter will be designed in practical 9. And in practical 10, designing of FIR filter using window technique using MATLAB program. Now first, we will be discussing here the first practical, which is a write a MATLAB program to plot real and complex exponential sequence. Now first, going into the MATLAB program, first we will study the theory of the related practical. Now here we know that the software which we'll be using is the MATLAB software. Now coming to the discrete time complex exponential, we know that any discrete time complex exponential is represented by say capital A e raised to power a n. Here a, or we can use here s also, where I can say that s is a complex number. S can be represented by sigma plus j omega. It is a complex number where sigma is the attenuation constant and omega is the angular frequency. Now this complex exponential, here we can see if I'll write omega as omega plus 2 pi, I will get again the expression e to the power j omega n. That means that this complex exponential repeat itself after every 2 pi period. So here we conclude that the complex exponential are always periodic signals. We have Euler's formula for a complex exponential, which is given by ejx cos x plus j sin x. But if we talk about the real exponentials are either decaying or growing exponentials. So real exponentials are never periodic in nature. They are non-periodic in nature. Now we'll start with the program code, which is written in the MATLAB. Here we will be plotting both real and complex exponential signal. Now first we will start with the plotting of the real exponential signal. Now first we will define the x-axis. Here, since we are going for discrete signal, for x-axis we have representation small n. First command is 0 is to 1 is to 25. That means small n varies from 0 to 25 with an interval of 1. Since n is always an integer, so interval of 1 is chosen. So we will have n starting from 0, 1, 2, and it will go up to 25. Now we will write function for real exponential, which is represented by y. It is represented by exp 0.2 into n. That means expression is given by y is equal to e raised to power 0.2 n. Now we want to plot this real exponential. So we will define a figure window which will be having a three waveforms. First will be real exponential, second will be the complex exponential, and third will have combination of real and complex exponential. So we will divide our figure window into three parts. So in this subplot parameter, we have written 3, 1. That means the figure window will have 3 rows and 1 column. And our real exponential signal will be plotted on first position. So here we have 1 written here. Since we are plotting discrete exponential signal, so for plotting, we will use the command stem command. So stem, on x-axis we have small n, and on y-axis we have function small y. Now, this will plot the real exponential signal. Now, for making the signal more explainable, we will add labels to the signal. So we will add x label small n and y label yn. And the title we will give real exponential signal. Now we will have complete signal which will have title and as well as x label and y label. Now this graph is shown here in first position. So here we can see the title is given real exponential sequence. X label is small n and y label is yn. So this will give me the real exponential signal. And from waveform, we can see that this is a growing exponential and this signal is not periodic. It is aperiodic in nature. Now, next we will plot complex exponential signal. Now again, we will define x-axis, which is represented by small n. It will vary from 0 to 50 with an interval of 1. We can write either, if we can write here 25, 100, we can increase the samples. This is on our program option. We can change it also. Now we will define a complex exponential, which is given by y is equal to exp I into 0.2 into pi into n. Since I is used here, that means it is a complex number. So it is represented by e raised to power I 0.2 pi n. So it will represent a complex exponential sequence. Now I will plot this sequence. So I will write subplot 3, 1, 2. 2 is written here because now this waveform will be located in the second position of the same figure window. Now, since discrete time signal is plotted, so I'll use stem command n, y because my expression is again represented by y. Now I'll give labels, x label n and y label I'll choose zn, and title will be complex exponential sequence. Now we will see the waveform for this complex exponential sequence. Now this is the second position where complex exponential sequence is plotted. Here we can see the x label n, y label zn, and the title is complex exponential sequence. Now the distinctive feature here, we can see that here the sequence is periodic in nature. We can see the samples repeating itself because it is a complex exponential sequence, whereas the real exponential sequence was non-periodic in nature. Now this is clear from the graph. Now next we will plot the combination of the real and exponential, a complex exponential sequence. So again I'll define x-axis. So n parameter will be written as 0 is to 1 is to 50. So it will vary from 0 to 50 with an interval of 1. Now I'll write an expression y is equal to exp 0.1 into n plus I into 0.2 into n. Now here we can see that we have real part in the form of 0.1 into n as well as complex part or imaginary part in the form of I into 0.2 into n. Now our exponential signal is given by y is equal to e raised to power 0.1 plus I 0.2 and whole multiplied by n. Now we will plot this. Now this plot will be in the third location. So I'll write subplot 3, 1, 3 and stem command will be used stem n, y. Now I'll add labels to the waveform. So x label n, y label cn, and the title will be real and complex exponential sequence because this sequence is having both real and imaginary part. Now we can see the third graph also. Here we have x label n, y label cn, and title is given real and complex exponential sequence. Now this is the plotting of the waveform. Now we can see that since it is a combination of real exponential sequence as well as complex exponential sequence, the sequence is not periodic in nature, rather it is non-periodic in nature. So here we can see that we have all the three waveforms. First is the real exponential, then complex exponential, then we have combination of real and complex exponential. So we have already done the MATLAB code for plotting all the three sequences, and here we can see the all the three plots in the same figure window. Now this is all for today. Thank you.